Dear Brittany.
Sometimes I run.
Christina. Shakira.
And humble, so you don't confuse them with mountains.
Celine.
Travel not to get to you. I travel not.
Chatters in your hand, we're like.
Are you the one who can break a glass?
Are you listening?
Sound.
You know when you're at a concert and you can feel the bass like in your chest?
Is the sound moving through you?
What is
sound?
Is it physical? Is it frequency?
Is it energy?
Is it a vibration? Why can't we see it?
But we can feel it.
So you know like the famous old myth where like an opera singer can break a wine glass with their voice? Will your perfect pitch break this wine glass? You're gonna use the vibration of your voice.
No, I'm not. Doesn't it have to be really high?
If you sing at the same pitch, it's going to combine with the frequency of this wine glass, I think, and shatter it.
No, it isn't.
You have to be pitch perfect for this experiment, but you have to do it at a certain decibel level.
I was max at 103. How am I gonna get another 7 decibels?
I'm going to go to an ENT, Dr. Jennifer Anderson, and she is going to scope your cords, give you advice on how to use your cords properly to break glass. Ew, it's like frosty from your breath. Look.
Stop.
That's messed up. Hold up. What exactly is sound? Say you get that text you've been waiting for and your phone starts to vibrate. Your phone vibrates, which causes the air to vibrate, which causes your eardrums to vibrate, which causes tiny ear bones called ossicles to vibrate, which translates these signals to your brain. These vibrations are caused by sound waves that travel through pretty much anything and everything. Except outer space. Sound doesn't have anything to vibrate through in outer space. But the interesting part is that each sound wave is unique and moves in a different way. A loud sound produces bigger waves that have higher peaks. They have more pressure and can travel a further distance, which is why you can hear them from a mile away. A quiet sound has a smaller swell and less pressure. This is measured in decibels, which ultimately tells us how loud the sound we are experiencing is. So then, why do we call some sounds high and some sounds low? That's because of the frequency of the vibration. That frequency is measured in hertz, which measures the number of waves that pass per second. The higher the frequency, the higher the pitch, and vice versa. Every object has its own natural frequency, aka the rate at which the atoms vibrate. So if Matt can match their voice to the natural frequency of the wine glass, then Matt will earn their mermaid status and, in theory, break the wine glass,
break the wine glass,
break the wine glass with their voice.
It's hard to get an appointment.
I know, you're a VIP baby.
When we get there, I'm gonna be like uncomfortable, perhaps. Your cords like rub together and that friction is what like creates the sound.
I thought they smack together like a walrus.
That's a glottal attack. That's how I heard you get nodes.
Nodes. Nodes. Rubbing together of your vocal cords at above average rates without proper lubrication. Nodes.
Have you ever used glottal fry?
It was like no big deal. I just kind of like do it anyway.
Right. She's gonna make you sing very high and very low. All so right. Maybe you should warm up a bit.
Option up.
The voice is warm.
Downtown Hospital is intense.
Hi.
Here to do the filming?
We are. Yeah. Last minute hydration.
Come on in here, we're gonna have a look at your voice. You get the picture.
Thank you.
Let's put a bit of freezing in. No allergies or anything?
No.
Which side of your nose to breathe through better? Left or right?
Today, this one.
Here we go, a little bit of spray.
Thank you. Where's freezing? It's going down the back of my throat.
Yeah, it's gonna make it a bit numb so I can see. This is gonna tell the stroke the frequency of your vibration, and we can receive that here. 92. Pretty good. Glottal fry though. Now take a breath. Go up as high as you can. Come down. You got about 575.
Lucas has a better range than me.
I'll never let you live it down.
Doesn't mean it's quality range. Just means it's there, okay? So sit forward nice and tall. And turn your head a little bit to the left.
I can feel it.
Can you? Okay.
In my throat.
Take a breath. You doing okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just take a breath and say hee hee hee.
Hee hee hee.
Now say e e e.
E e e.
Okay, take a breath now. Very good. A little throat clear. Okay. And try the glottal fry if you can.
I'm good.
Yeah, you did a great job.
I've never seen my cords before. I've never done this.
Ew, that was disgusting. What did we just watch?
When the cords hit each other, yeah. Is that what's creating sound?
Dr. Anderson explained it like this. You take a breath and the lungs are full of air. Think of it as the fuel. These air molecules are the ones that are going to vibrate. You shut your cords and then you start to exhale slowly. The surface of the cords will ripple and a teeny bit of air comes out. Those air particles set the ones in front in motion. They bounce into each other and then the walls and so on. The sound you make when you cough is created by squeezing the vocal cords together. Glottal fry is when you close the cords completely and pop them back open again. And that's how you get sound. But how do you get volume?
Are you the one who can break a glass?
Dr. DeLuca seemed to know how. Told you. And after some coaching and much trial and error.
And this is your journey.
Let it just go wherever it wants to go to get loud.
Okay.
Okay, I'll go.
Take a deep breath.
Whoa!
107 decibels.
Matt got to 107 decibels.
You need 3 more decibels.
Music is all around us.
Let's face it, this seemed hard. So the next day we got the entire No Brainers team to get together and give it a try. 6 heads are better than 1, right?
You'll hear it sing back.
We sounded a little something like this. But in my head, it went more like this. We tried a variety of glasses and sang close to the glass to make sure the wine glass was receiving the frequency at the maximum decibel level. We even tried singing together to amplify the sound. The glass was vibrating and singing back at us, but it was exhausting trying to sing the exact frequency of the wine glass at our maximum decibel level. And quite frankly, it hurt.
I'm gonna pass out.
What if you go back to the doctor?
Come on, baby.
There was no way we could keep singing this loud for long. And we needed something to increase our longevity, so we eventually set up a speaker to amplify the decibel level. We sang at the glass for hours, but finally we ran out of juice. I was getting stressed. Matt and Laura were losing their voices. And Marianne wouldn't stop singing. Even my boss took a crack at it. But sooner or later, we had to accept. We couldn't crack the glass. I didn't know what to do. I had seen this was possible, and I couldn't figure out what we had done wrong. Nobody believed we could do it. Even my boss told us to call it quits. But I couldn't be defeated. I went back to the books and discovered I may have used the wrong type of glass. So I thrifted used crystal wine glasses that were less dampened than the new ones. I chose a frequency that I could sustain for a long time, and I locked myself in our studio to prove to Matt that it could be done. I could literally feel the wine glass vibrating in my hand, and it was singing louder than ever, but when I used a vocal tuner app, I noticed that I was often a tiny bit off the frequency of the wine glass.
I'm sharp, I can feel it, I can hear it.
The louder and longer I sang, the less I could control my pitch.
I thought I was always kind of flat.
I even tried cutting the top of the glass to give it a head start on the crack. Nothing. Until it hit me. The way to get the exact frequency was to use the sound of the wine glass against itself. I recorded the frequency of the glass and I put it on a loop on my computer. I set up my laptop to a microphone and amplified the sound with 2 giant speakers on both sides. This had to work. The wine glass was singing and shaking so quick my eye could barely catch it. I put a pencil in the glass and it was vibrating back and forth, which proved that the pitch was matched perfectly. I waited, and finally, okay, so it wasn't the mind-blowing shatter I expected, but it cracked, and it felt amazing.
Okay, we got it.
So what did we learn? Sound waves are literally traveling through us 24 hours a day. Like a snowflake, each one is unique with a different tone and frequency that is almost impossible to recreate. There are sound waves traveling all around us at frequencies that we can't even hear that can change our mood and well-being. And even though we can't see sound, it very much exists and has the power to connect us to the people we love.
I'll do it from the window side.
I broke the glass.
No, you didn't. Stop!
Oh. I didn't tell you it was on Friday.
But the power of sound.
So, I encourage you, make sound. Use your voice in any way you can. And don't forget to listen to the sounds around you. timbres, the frequencies, the harmonies. It's one of life's magical gifts that we take for granted every single day. And let us know in the comments, what do you think about sound?